Welcome back to AJSpeller.com. In today's tutorial, we're going to work on a related rates problem. And here we have a 25-foot ladder is leaning against the wall of a house. The base of the ladder is pulled away from the wall at a rate of 2 feet per second. Find the rate at which the angle between the ladder and the wall of the house is changing when the base of the ladder is 7 feet, 15 feet, and 24 feet from the wall. All right, we begin by having several pieces of information that were given. We're going to start off with x being 7 feet, meaning the bottom of the ladder is 7 feet away from the wall. We can calculate the y value, which would have been 24 feet. Dx dt is also given at 2 feet per second. We see that here. And dy dt is the negative 7 twelfths feet per second, and we calculated that in a previous tutorial. And I'll be sure to add the link to the previous tutorial to this tutorial. Right here, we're trying to find this angle here and this angle theta, where this here is the wall, this here is the ladder, and this side down here is the ground. All right, we know that the length of the ladder is 25. We're going to call the ground here x. We're going to call the wall here y. We could use any other trig functions to solve this, but we're going to use sine for this problem here. So we're going to take the sine of the angle, so sine theta, and remember sine is the opposite side over the hypotenuse, so this here is going to be x over 25. So we have sine theta is equal to x over 25. At this point I'm going to cross cancel, so I end up with x is equal to 25 sine theta. And now I need to take the implicit differentiation with respect to time, because I want to figure out what that angle is going to be at a particular moment in time. So to do that, I take the derivative of x, which is just 1, and then I multiply 1 times the factor dx dt, because I'm taking the derivative with respect to time. I keep my constant here, 25, and then I take the derivative of sine, which turns out to be cosine theta. And again, because I'm taking the derivative with respect to time, I need to tack on the factor d theta dt. At this point, I'm going to make some substitutions. Dx dt, we know, is 2. I'm going to keep the constant of 25. Cosine theta, well, to figure out cosine, I know that the ground, the bottom of the ladder, is going to be 7 feet from the wall, so I know x is 7. And using the Pythagorean theorem, I figure out that y is 24. So now, if I'm trying to evaluate cosine of theta, well, cosine is going to be the adjacent side, which is 24, over the hypotenuse, which is 25. So at this point, that is going to be the fraction 24 25ths. So I substitute in the 24 25ths, and then I still have the factor d theta dt. And now I can do some simplification. This 25 is over 1, so I can do some canceling here. And I end up with 2 is equal to 24 d theta dt. And to get d theta dt by itself, I'm going to divide both sides by 24. And in doing so, those 24s cancel. And I see that d theta dt actually turns out to be 1 over 12. And that's really going to be 1 over 12 radians per second. So when the bottom of the ladder is 7 feet from the wall, this angle theta is changing at 1 12th radians per second. All right, let's move on to our next example. In this example, again, we're going to put in what we know. Here is the ladder at 25 feet. We're going to call the ground x and the wall y. And this here is the angle in question, theta. All right, we just did sine, so now we're going to do cosine. So I want to find the cosine of theta. Well, cosine is the adjacent side, which is going to be y over the hypotenuse, 25. So this here is cosine theta is equal to y 25ths. Again, I'm going to cross multiply, and I end up with y is equal to 25 cosine theta. Now I need to take the derivative of both sides with respect to t, or the implicit differentiation. So the derivative of y is 1, and then 1 times the factor dy dt. Keep the constant 25. And the derivative of cosine is negative sine. So I'm going to place the negative in front of the 25 and then place in my sine theta. And again, the factor d theta dt, because it's implicit differentiation with respect to time. At this point, I'm going to do my substitutions. dy dt, we see is a negative 3 halves, is equal to negative 25. And now I'm trying to find the sine of theta. Well, I know that x is 15. And if x is 15 by the Pythagorean theorem, I know that y has to be 20. So now, to take the sine of this particular triangle, sine is going to be the opposite side over the hypotenuse. Well, that's going to be 15 25ths. So I'm going to multiply by 15 over 25. And I have the factor d theta dt. Remember, this negative 25 is over 1. I could do some simplification. So these 25s cancel. So this here is actually a negative 1 here. So I end up with, and let me rewrite it here. So negative 3 halves is equal to a negative 15 d theta dt. I'm going to divide both sides by the negative 15. In doing so, these negative 15s cancel. I end up with d theta dt is equal to the negative 3 halves over negative 15. And I'm going to write this as negative 15 over 1. So I have a complex fraction. So what I can do here is write the complex numerator as the negative 3 halves. My division turns to multiplication. And then I write the reciprocal of the denominator, which just means to flip it. So this becomes a negative 1 over 15. Well, I have a negative times a negative, which says it's going to be positive. So 3 times 1 to give me 3. And then 2 times 15 to give me 30. And then here I have 30. I'm sorry, I have 3 over 30. Both of these numbers can be divided by 3. So I end up with 1/10. And again, the units are going to be radians per second. So at the moment that the base of the ladder is 15 feet away from the wall, this angle theta is changing at 1/10 radians per second. And now let's move on to our last example here. All right, in this last example, again, this is the angle. Let's change the color. This here is the angle that we're talking about, theta. This here is x. Again, this here is y. And this is the ladder at 25 feet. We just did sine and cosine. Let's go ahead and do tangent now. So here we're going to do the tangent of theta. Well, tangent is the opposite side over the adjacent. So this is going to be x over y. All right, again, I'm going to cross multiply like I did in all the other ones. So we have 1 times x to give me x. So I have x is equal to tangent theta times y. Take the derivative, or the implicit differentiation, of both sides with respect to time. So the derivative of x is 1. And then because I took the derivative of x, I need to write in the factor dx dt. Now I'm going to use the product rule. I'm going to write my first factor, which is tangent theta. And I'm going to multiply that by the derivative of the second factor, which is y. Derivative of y is 1, but I also need to tack on the factor dy dt. And then I'm going to add that to where I'm going to take the second factor, which is y, and just write that, and multiply that times the derivative of the first factor. And the derivative of tangent is secant squared theta, and that has to also be multiplied by the factor d theta dt because of the implicit differentiation with respect to time. At this point, I'm going to do several substitutions. Dx dt, we know, is 2. Tangent theta, well, I need to figure that out. When x is 24, by the Pythagorean theorem, we know that y has to be 7. So to find the tangent of theta, well, tangent is the opposite over the adjacent, so that's going to be 24 over 7. Then I'm going to multiply that by dy dt. Well, dy dt is negative 48 over 7. Then I need to add on y, which is 7. And I'm going to multiply that by secant squared. And remember that secant theta is the same thing as 1 over cosine theta. So I'm just going to find cosine theta, and then I'm going to flip the, I'm going to change the numerator and denominator. I'm going to swap them. So if I'm here at theta to find cosine, that's going to be the adjacent over the hypotenuse. So it should be 7 over 25, but I need to flip it. So I'm going to make it 25 over 7. And remember, this is saying secant squared, so that means I need to take this value and actually square it. And I don't know what d theta dt is right now. All right, my next step, I want to take this term here and move this term to the left-hand side. So actually, I'm going to subtract this term from both sides. Notice it's already a negative, so that's going to make it positive, because if I were to combine this, it would be negative. So this here I have, it's going to turn into 2 plus 24 sevenths times 48 sevenths to equal 7 times 25 sevenths squared d theta dt. Again, I want to get this d theta dt by itself, so I'm going to divide both sides by these factors that we see here. So 7 times the 25 sevenths squared, and I'm going to divide this side here by 7 times the 25 sevenths squared. So all these factors here cancel, and when you simplify this, this here turns out to just be 2 sevenths. So this here is really 2 sevenths radians per second. Alright, and again, to explain what that means, when the foot of the ladder is 24 feet away from the wall, this angle here, theta, is changing at 2 sevenths radians per second. Alright, well, that sums up this tutorial by ajspeller.com, and as always, thank you for watching.